you guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Shohini Sarkar and today I will be talking about sustainable fashion. By now we have all heard the term sustainable fashion, but we do not properly know what actually sustainable fashion means. So I am here to tell everything about sustainable fashion to you. I will be talking about what is sustainable fashion, why it is so important, and how is it harming the environment, and how did the movement of sustainable fashion emerge. So let's get going. So what is sustainable fashion? It is very important to understand what sustainable fashion is. I will quickly read out what Wikipedia says. So according to Wikipedia, sustainable fashion is a movement or process of fostering change to fashion products or fashion system towards greater ecological and social integrity. A rather simply definition by Emily Chan for an article for Vogue says that sustainable fashion is an umbrella for clothes that are created and consumed in a way that can literally be sustained while protecting the environment. To keep it short, sustainable fashion is the kind of fashion that we need to adopt in our life to protect the environment, to protect people around us, and obviously to protect us. Basically, we can sum it up that if you want a one word for sustainable fashion, then you can tell eco-friendly fashion. But in 2021, sustainable fashion is much, much more than what eco-friendly fashion is. Sustainable fashion is not just about protecting the environment. It is also about protecting the workers who work to produce clothes for us, to protect ourselves, to protect the environment. It speaks a broader meaning in 2021. As we become more aware, sustainable fashion discovers new meaning every single day. Question is, why am I talking of sustainable fashion? See, talking about nature, talking about environment and protecting the environment, taking a step towards environment is never a bad time, and you are never late. Plus, the fashion industry is producing increasing damage to the environment every single day. Mahatma Gandhi once said that there is enough for everyone's need, but not enough for everyone's greed. So if you think this statement mindfully, and you will realize that this has a much, much deeper meaning, because there is actually enough for everyone's need. I can have 10 pair of clothes, good clothes, and I can spend my life. But I want more clothes. I want the greed in people. There is never gonna be enough for anyone's greed. So that's what Mahatma Gandhi says, and this statement is also true in other aspects of life, not only fashion. So we should all be taking notes from this quotation by Mahatma Gandhi. So how does fashion affects our environment? That is a critical question. When I was not aware of this topic, I used to think that how is it related. Now I'm going to tell you how is it related. First, let's start by using the most basic fabric or fabric we see in our daily life always, that is cotton, which makes up to 1/3 of the total fabric produced globally. So by an article by Emily Chan on Vogue, she spoke about the harmful effects of growing cotton, which can lead to soil fertility loss and also soil degradation. And growing cotton can also lead to loss of habitat, and while growing cotton, loss of harmful pesticides are used, which create soil damage. So what are pesticides? Pesticides are basically chemicals which are used to eliminate pests and insects that interfere in the growing of crops. Next is leather, which we all love to see in fashion industry. We all love to wear. I've never worn leather. So it is a product of livestock farming. What is livestock farming? Livestock farming is basically growing of animals, nourishing of animals for human use. So you will be shocked to know that the leather is responsible for 70% of deforestation of Amazon rainforest. When I came to know about this, this had completely left me in shock. 70 freaking percentage of deforestation of Amazon rainforest. Next is a disruption of food chain. Now, if a food chain is a chain for balance of food and what we eat, like we depend on animals, animals depend on some other thing, it's a total circle. So if anyone in the food chain or anything in the food chain is disrupted, we all are affected. We all are screwed, basically. not to forget that every year millions of plastics from fabrics are dumped in the ocean, and this produces greenhouse emission, which is produces greenhouse effect, and which is a very big loss for our ecosystem, very big damage or loss for our ecosystem. According to an article on fashionmatters.com or sustainablefashionmatters.com, it speaks about how washing the clothes can infuse the environment with harmful chemicals. And this is so true, but we actually do not know what to do about it. Should we not wash our clothes, or should we if we do not wash our clothes, then we have to throw it, right? So if we throw it, that's a direct harm to the environment. So we all are figuring out ways in which we can be sustainable. We can take a step towards protecting the environment. By now, it is very clear that how important sustainable development is or sustainable fashion is. Now, I will quickly read out what is the origin of sustainable fashion. So in 1962, publication of Silent Spring by an American biologist, Rachel Carson, exposed widespread and serious pollution associated with the use of agricultural chemical related to today's environment and social impact of fashion. Later in 1992, when there was systematic investigation, thorough investigation, then they actually found out how the environment is polluted by the fashion industry. We should all be thankful to Rachel Carson, because she actually first brought this concept of sustainable fashion. She actually observed this problem in our environment without anybody else observing, and she is the reason why we are also getting aware these days. So I hope I'm clear. I hope I am clear to you. I hope you are able to get, or you are able to find what sustainable fashion means. And to sum it up, it is eco-friendly fashion. It is fashion that protects the environment. I am also doing research, more and more research on sustainable fashion, and I will come up with more videos on sustainable fashion. I am so glad that you are watching till now. But if you want to go sustainable, fashionable, if that's the thing, then there are many ways in which you can do so, which I will be speaking about in later videos. So I hope you like this video. I hope this video helped you in any way. Share this with your friends and also make them aware. Subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and do not forget to share. My name is Shivani Sarkar. I will see you in my next video. Thank you for watching. Signing off.